Here's a question for the philosophers out there. What sets humans apart from other animals? We could ask Descartes or Rousseau, but here's one answer. Humans use complex tools and supplies, ones of our own design and making. Shelters, weapons, clothing, toys. In the earliest days, the making process was simple. Raw materials plus human labor yielded a useful output. Each of these processes, even the most simple, can be called manufacturing. Soon, we started making outputs for the purpose of making other outputs more efficiently. A mill for grinding meal more easily. A potter's wheel for molding jars and bowls more consistently. And the layers only grew. Outputs used to make outputs used to make other outputs. The potter's wheel makes a jug, which is used to make dye, which colors fabric, and so on. In the 18th century, this layering saw a massive step change in complexity. The machines we built for the purpose of making other outputs were more advanced than ever. The cotton gin, the spinning jenny, and the steam engine, for example. The manufacturing equation suddenly started to look very different. Far less labor was needed. Machines were doing the work. Since then, manufacturing has undergone wave after wave of revolution in the technologies and techniques that are used. Driving all of these advances? The relentless pursuit of optimization, using as little labor and as few materials as possible, and doing it all quickly. For manufacturing companies, achieving best-in-class processes is critical to success. Being competitive on cost and product quality depends on it. But achieving best-in-class means chasing a constantly advancing goal. Perhaps the most famous case of a manufacturing paradigm shift is the Toyota production system, called TPS, a methodology that emerged in the mid-20th century. Toyota was clearly doing something different, and it was working. Others took note and sought to replicate elements of their approach, which laid the groundwork for what later became lean manufacturing, a philosophy that emphasizes waste reduction. Today, companies like Tesla are having a similarly disruptive impact. Tesla's so-called gigafactories aren't just producing next-generation electric vehicles. They're leading the way in applying cutting-edge tools and techniques, both via robotic machines and AI-powered software operating the machines. They've even announced ambitious plans to introduce thousands of humanoid robots into its factories. To stay competitive, others will have to keep up. Continuous improvement is indeed the essence of manufacturing. In this primer, we will cover the foundational manufacturing concepts, the different types of manufacturing, the metrics used, common optimization approaches, how manufacturing teams are organized, and the key trends.